Hello, it's Mick from Jester Bushcraft. I've put together a little Tinder box using an old pocket hand warmer, and also I've incorporated some of the punk wood that I found on a previous video, and I just wanted to go through it today and show you how you can use it for firelighting. When I got the punk wood, it was very wet. So before it dried out, I sliced it up into little pieces and then dried it out, made drying it out a lot quicker as well. And I've just put a piece in there, and at the end there I've also got some char cloth. But today I'm going to be using the punk wood. So that just sits in there. It's secured with a Ranger band made of bicycle inner tube, which of course is also a good form of firelighter. And for the purpose of the video, I'm going to be using some natural garden twine, which I've just fluffed up, which is going to simulate dried grass or something like that. I've also got some sheep's wool as well, which I'll try, and we're going to see if we can get a little fire going. So I've got the punk wood in there, all nice and dry. I'm just going to scrape some bits of the rod onto the punk wood. Some little scrapings on. And then we're going to try and get an ember spark onto the punk wood. Straight away. You can see that. This punk wood is great. So now we're going to put the string on. Take the tin away. I think I might have been a bit hasty with all my sticks there. You can see how I got a flame going from that. Still, I've got some embers there. We've actually still got a bit of an ember on. It's gone onto the char. chalk off. The chalk off is burning quite well there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try a bit more string. I think I was a bit hasty with the twigs there. They weren't right for what I was doing, which is why preparation is the key. You can see my char cloth is burning away nicely there. Got a nice little ember on that. So we'll just fluff some of this string up. Oh, that sheep's wool does not stink. And it burns. Charcoal still going, burning over there. Just shows how good that stuff is. All fingers and thumbs here. Wow, that stuff goes quick. Well, the tinder box is a success. That works really well. Still got an ember on there. But my preparation skills have got a bit to be desired. So there you go, there's the tinder box. I just need a bit more preparation with my bits and pieces, maybe a bit of an intermediate tinder, a bit more dry grass or something like that. I'm only limited there with the string. It soon burns out, doesn't give me enough time to get the sticks on and catch. So lesson learned there, but the tinder box works well. All my punk wood has gone, so I'm ready for my next piece now. I need to get some more pieces in there. Okay, we'll see you on the next video. I wasn't giving up that easily. I had to give it another go. Persistence has paid off. I'm not going to get much of a fire going here. I'm just doing it for practice, really. So that was the pocket hand warmer with punk wood, which took a spark really well. Just ground some shavings onto the punk wood and then ignited it. And then I ended up using the char cloth as well. So I think this will be a nice little addition to my grab bag. It's a little fire starting kit. So I've always got a way of starting a fire. And keeps it nice and sealed in there. I've got the Ranger band just to go around, which I can also use for fire lighting if need be. And it comes in a little drawstring bag, and I've got a little packet of char cloth and another little packet for keeping the string in as well, the natural garden twine. And that just fits nicely in my bag. So there we go. Fire from the pocket hand warmer tinderbox. See you on the next video.